Korean Airlines is in talks with partner Delta for a joint venture in a move that would give the second largest U.S. carrier a bigger foothold in Asia, where rising incomes are fueling a boom in air travel. Gina Cervetti, Bloomberg Radio.
7:39, News Talk 620, WVMT Newstime. Adam Hergenrother, Hergenrother.com. AdamHergenrother.com. I'm getting them all.
I get them all confused,
man,
too.
I think you have a new website every week.
Yeah, I know. We do.
You are a busy, busy guy.
Yeah.
Now, I know you've got your training seminar coming up. It's a ways off, but we're urging people to register for this event. It is a single day event, all day event, on April 27th from 9 to 4, and it's called Business Without Limits, Vermont. Behind the scenes look at some of the models and things that you've worked on and the way that you've built your empire, and you're going to be sharing some of those. I don't call them secrets, but because if they were, you wouldn't be telling them.
Yeah. Well, there's certainly no secrets, and I didn't invent them, but one of the things that I love to do is to certainly get people to think differently. And I think if we can accelerate a lot of the companies that are in Vermont, and we've been doing this for the past 4 years outside of Vermont. And then one of the things is when we have an 80-person training room in our new facility, and we'll be in there on March 24th. So that's the date we're moving in. So I'm really excited about it. You'll see a grand opening party. But one of the benefits is we've been partnering with a lot of other firms around here of bringing in speakers together, because not everybody has an 80-person facility that's state of the art for teaching. And so I know everyone is involved with personal growth. So this is a kind of a way of, hey, coming in here, I'm going to share the models and systems that I've learned from mentors who are billionaires that I meet pretty much monthly with, and then giving them to everybody, but also just a way of coming to check out our facilities and our building so they can bring other people in there as well too.
So Adam, when we first introduced you to our audience, it was Adam Hergenrother with KW Vermont Keller Williams Realty, selling homes. And when you talk about this event that you've got coming up, just to be clear, it isn't about marketing homes.
Yeah, no,
it isn't about selling homes.
Yeah. I mean, it's about building business, about personal growth. I mean, business is nothing but a conduit for your own personal growth. And that's just what I've used. And, you know, and when I started out as a real estate agent, and I still sell real estate. But as that progressed, we opened up Keller Williams, now the number one real estate company in the state of Vermont for number of agents. And then from there, we moved to BlackRock, to investing, to syndication, to training. And it's just
BlackRock is a construction firm.
Yeah. We have a foundation. We put on those events. So it's all kind of – really what it is as you get really good people in your organization, you have to get out of the way. So I've fired myself pretty much from every position that I've ever had and allowed other people's gifts to shine through. And that's a complicated – from our organization.
Vermont Business Magazine that said that your companies were one of the best places to work.
Yeah, we just got ranked one of the best places to work. I think that's it's all throughout the state of Vermont, so we're pretty happy about that and excited about just the testament to our people that work there as well, too.
Let's just quickly talk about what is going on in real estate. What's happening with the market? I know the new construction, what's happening there, and is this a good time to buy or sell a home?
You know, numbers don't lie, which is why I love moving from emotional conversations to numeric ones. And right now you're seeing a tremendous amount of inventory move. It got slow for December and January, and you saw a decrease in housing. But what's interesting thing is right now it's really, really come back strong. So we have more buyers than we can put homes in right now. And so if you're thinking about listing your home, I mean, we're listing and selling homes within 24 to 36 hours in February right now. And we listed one and sold it for $7,000 above asking price.
Is there a fear that interest rates are going to go up?
Well,
it's almost every day in the business news you see interest rates going to go up again.
I think it's a combination. It's also when other people start seeing other people buy, it causes them to go out there and want to purchase as well too, for a whole variety of reasons. And new construction, you know, one of the things, I was in Vegas for a whole trade conference, is if you look at it, new construction is everywhere. It's not just in Vermont, it's grown there, but we're still about 300,000 units every year below capacity, meaning below what we should be building. There's room for more, and it's still growing, but people are taking baby steps because of how bad they got hurt. So until we see that number go back up to a little over 1 million units a year, right now it's hovering around 780,000 units of new construction built every year, you're still going to see that shortage, and that shortage causes people to go out and want to bid on higher homes, and that's why you're seeing some of those prices drive up.
We're still hurt from 2008.
Yeah, we definitely are. And builders, and rightfully so, are just in banks, right, are holding back on on some of the lending. They're holding back on purchasing any potential land that will cause larger developments. So, you know, all those things are factoring into pricing.
Okay, again, Adam Hergenrother, hergtraining.com. You can check out that website, H-E-R-G, hergtraining.com. Find out more information about Business Without Limits. This seminar, all-day seminar from 9 to 4. Lunch is included. It'll be in South Burlington. Adam, always good to see you.
Great to see you as well, too.
Thanks for joining us this morning. 7:43 on WVMT. Time for Rush.
Okay. Yep. An illegal immigrant from El Salvador, Esteban Rafael Marquez Velasquez. Any other host could do that. Walked out of